Hey guys, Captain Henson here. So in today's video, I'll be talking about the sequel to AVP Prey, AVP Hunter's Planet. Now, unlike Prey and then AVP War, this book is actually an original story, not based on, or not an added novelization of a comic. So it's interesting in that regard, and I'm pretty sure it's the only Bantam, Alien, or Predator book that it's an original piece. So, that's certainly interesting. So, what's this one about? Now, despite what the cover will have you believe, this doesn't focus on Machiko's time with the Predator tribe. That's relegated to what's essentially a flashback. The story takes place some time after she leaves the Predator tribe, and pretty much just going back to the company of the first book and trying to live some kind of life. She meets this very, very, very wealthy guy who's running this game planet, essentially, the titular Hunter's Planet, where they grow and clone species, set them loose on the planet, and let people hunt them. And, of course, given that this is a Predator story, well, the Predators, this is their, one of their hunting grounds. And also, because this is an alien story, well, you know. So, I will say, after I got over the initial disappointment of this not focusing on Machiko's time with the tribe, I gotta say, this is a really good read. While it's not the focus, we do see the effects being what the Predators had on her. And we do see her try to live some kind of normal life. And it's certainly interesting in that regard. Now, later on in the, like with Prey, Machiko has to team up with a predator, or this time, the tribe of predators that are hunting on the planet. Because, well, the guy who brought her on, or brought her in, well, he's experimenting with the xenomorphs. You know, creating hybrids, cyborgs. Of course, predators don't like that, so Machiko, few mercenaries and the predators team up and put a stop to it. I don't have much to say on this book, unfortunately. But if you enjoyed AVP Prey, you're going to enjoy this. It continues Machiko's story. We get to see more of the Predators and how they do things. And get to see more of the world. More of the alien Predator world. From what I understand, this story is retconned thanks to AVP War, both the comic and its novelization. So, it's a one-off, essentially, but it's a good end, in my opinion, to Machiko's story. At least an ending, given what we get with AVP 3 World War. So, what did you guys think of AVP Hunter's Planet? Do you think it worked well as a sequel? Let me know in the comments section below. Until next time, this is Captain Henson signing off.